Alrighty, folks, so today we're going to talk about administering transdermal medications. If you get a medication from us, you're going to receive this sheet with it that's going to walk through all these bullet points, and it's going to have a picture of a cat's ear to show you specifically where you're going to be putting this medication. However, we're still going to go ahead and go through it in this video so that you can have a physical representation of what these bullet points mean. Some important key things to remember are that you always want to be wearing gloves when applying this medication. We do so because the medication is designed to be absorbed across the skin of your cat's ear, and that means that you could absorb it across your skin as well. We want to make sure that we clean the ears prior to administering the medication and alternate ears between use to prevent irritation. To clean the ears, you can use cotton balls with water or a generic ear cleaning solution. We're going to talk about some different administration modes through commercially available products versus compounded products. This mirtazapine is the only currently commercially available product, and it's going to come in a tube as such with a metal tip and a screw off top, as you can see here. These medications will be dispensed in a length dose per se, and the box will have an example of what a proper single dose is. This one is 1.5 inches, and you can use that to guide you in giving the medication. However, if you do get a compounded medication, it could come in various different syringes or pens. You could have a large syringe as shown here, or you could have a 1 mL syringe, for example. If your dose is 0.25 mils and you have a 1 mL syringe, you would start with a full syringe and give one dose up to the 0.75 mark. Then the next dose would go from the 0.75 mark to the 0.5 mark, and so on until you reach the end of the syringe. If you have a pen, however, it could click or turn, and these click or turn would give you exactly one dose, and you would then just use that to dispense the medication. You want to make sure that you're rubbing this medication in completely, and you want to make sure to keep small kids and other pets away from the animal that has the medication if they're likely to mess with the ear so that they're not absorbing the medication as well. So now we have our little friend here to show you how we're going to administer this transdermal medication. I find that it's easier than giving oral medication sometimes, but still not always their favorite thing in the world to have to do. So having them backed up against you or in your lap, or being able to put a little bit of your pressure on them so that they can't squirm away, tends to be helpful. Like we talked about before, you want to make sure that you clean out the pinna of the ear before administering the medication. And then you're going to use your syringe to get a little bit of the medication, whatever the dose is, onto the pinna of the ear. And you're going to rub it in using your gloved hands. If they're willing to stay still and just look around a little bit, you can give them a little bit of freedom. But you want to make sure that you get a chance to rub it all the way in. And again, you want to keep other pets and kids away for the first couple hours, and you can offer them some treats as reinforcement if they are willing to take them to make it a more positive experience.